May his soul rest in eternal peace. Meanwhile, President Yoweri Museveni has declined to the Sexual Offences Bill and the Succession Amendment Bill and returned them back to Parliament for reconsideration. Now, the president says that 80% share of deceased property, which was allocated to the surviving spouse, is too much and could cause a lot of conflict in families. Now, we have the details in the following report.
Succession Amendments Bill is dated 22nd July 2021, an address to the Speaker of Parliament.
Today, parliamentary sittings returned to original chambers after 1.5 years of working under tents as a measure of observing COVID-19 preventive SOPs. It's from today's sitting that the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Anita Mongin, announced that the President had rejected the two gender-related bills which were passed by Parliament in May. Museveni says the Sexual Offences Bill is not necessary since it's a duplication of the Penal Code Act and the Judicial Review Commission is considering amendments over the same.
The letter is dated 3rd August 2021, addressed to the Speaker of Parliament of Uganda. The above subject matter refers. I have received the Sexual Offences Bill Act 2021 for assent. However, the bill needs to be reviewed because, one, there are several provisions of the Act that are already provided for in the legislations.
The President also disagreed with the provisions of the Succession Amendment Bill regarding the sharing of the deceased property. The amendment had given the surviving spouse 80% of the deceased property and 20% to the dependent relatives. But Museveni says this will create conflicts between the widow and relatives of the deceased, and he wants the widow to take 50%, the dependent relatives 49%, and 1% remains for a customary heir.
I have received the Succession Amendments Bill 2021 for assent. However, there are sanctions listed below that need to be reconsidered and reviewed by Parliament. 1. Clause 14, which seeks to replace Section 27 of the Principal Act, introduced a new arrangement of sharing property where a spouse has died in a state. Under Clause 14C, where an in a state is survived by a spouse, an dependent relative, but no living descendants, the spouse shall receive 80% and the dependent relative shall receive 20% of the whole property of the estate. This is a complete departure from the earlier provisions of the law. While no clear justification, it will interfere with the beneficiary's interest.
However, members of Parliament have received this disagreement with mixed reactions.
The law says when the bill is sent to the President for signing, if the President is not satisfied, within 30 days, he should communicate and return it back to Parliament. Now we see it, after 3-4 months, the bill comes to the floor of Parliament. This is an indication that the President does not respect Parliament at all.
What I see is that we are not yet ready for that bill. We are not ready for it. I think it was hurried, in my opinion. We are forced to, in my opinion, we had to debate because it has come, but we needed much more time on this bill. Besides that, there are already laws which are handling issues of sexual offences. The Penal Code Act is there, and other laws are already in existence. The Succession Bill, the word, there are so many where a few areas are already being consolidated into this bill.
We need to be very clear and draw a distinction between Islamic or religious affairs with secular laws. Unfortunately, being a Muslim, I'm a strong believer of our law that is established by the Quran, the Sharia law. It categorically stipulates who benefits what from the estate of the deceased.
Some members of parliament are opposed to the president's proposal of allocating 49% to dependent relatives, saying it's not necessary since they contribute less to the deceased's wealth.
I think this bill, however much president has refused to sign it, but when you look at the real perspective of the matter, you see that the dependent and the heir, they have not been contributing on what they have. So to me, I think the surviving spouse should be given that percentage, the 80%.
Parliament has given line ministers only 2 weeks to retable these bills to be considered by the Legal Affairs Committee. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.